hands warm yet? Oh, there's still a little. So your hands are so warm. Are your hands warm? Oh, yeah, Madison. Are your hands warm? Yes. I want to talk to you about something that I used to do when I was very little. I used to daydream. You know what daydream means? What's daydreaming mean? It means when you dream in the daytime. You know about daydreaming, Weenie? Do you daydream? I used to sit at my desk and the teacher would be talking and explaining math or science, and I'd be looking out the window, looking around, thinking about riding my bicycle. And if I was Dominic, I'd be thinking about Ghostbusters. What do you think about when you daydream? Princesses. When you daydream, you might be thinking about, when's my next snack? When's my next nap? Right? But daydreaming is what? When I'm daydreaming and I'm not listening to my teacher, I'm doing what? I'm daydreaming, I'm distracted. I'm not looking at the teacher, I'm not listening to the teacher, I'm not learning, right? And so when you're daydreaming, you're not paying attention, right? What does paying attention mean? What does that mean, Dominic?
It means that you're paying attention to the teacher.
And it means listening. Yes, listening. Good, good. So we always, as we grow up, want to make sure we're paying attention and we're listening when it's time to listen. And when it's time to daydream, it's okay to daydream. It's good. That's part of thinking. That's part of learning too. But we have to make sure when someone's talking to us that we're listening, right? Paying attention. Jesus had a lot of things to say. And some people paid attention and some people didn't. But Jesus wants us to understand the lesson that Jesus has for us is to be listening for God to talk to us. Right? Do you think God talks to you? Right. And we have to listen. We have to pay attention. And one of the best ways to pay attention to God is to be quiet. Put your hands together and just sit. And listen with your heart. Not so much with your ears, but what do you feel? Do you feel love? Do you feel maybe God has something special for you? And so today I want you to put your hands together with me. And I want you to listen. Sometimes when it's so quiet, all we can hear is the beating of our hearts. Or sometimes we hear a little bit of noise from moving. And sometimes our youngest friends remind us that they're alive. That's okay. And then sometimes when we're listening, we just feel like we want to say something to God. Like, thank you. Thank you, God, for this day, for our life, for our friends and our family, for our mom and dad, our uncle and aunts, our grandparents. Thank you for showing us love. Thank you, Lord, for giving us a place to be on a Sunday morning where we can call our home. And Lord, I thank you for these children and all that they are and all that they will be, because they listen to your words. They grow in understanding and in faith and in truth. It's in your holy name we pray. Amen. Thank you for coming up and listening and paying attention to me. And I hope that you'll learn something today somewhere. Somehow, about God's love for you. Never forget that God loves you so very much. I'll see you soon at communion time. Did I know there was a new? Thank you for paying attention to me. Now I'm going to pay attention to you. I do not know there's a new Ghostbusters sound.
Ghostbusters 3, it's all new.
Oh, interesting. We'll hear about this later, okay? Thank you for coming up. We'll see you soon.